Hello, today I'll make some NAP. NAP is nickel aminoguanidine perchlorate, a powerful primary explosive. If you don't know what is it, please watch these two videos first. I grouped them into a playlist, link will be in the description. This video is only about its synthesis. Making NAP is quite a simple process once you have aminoguanidine bicarbonate and perchloric acid. Here I am preparing nickel perchlorate by dropwise addition of perchloric acid to nickel carbonate. In the end, I got clear, slightly acidic solution. Then I added aminoguanidine bicarbonate to this solution. Nothing happened. Then I turned aminoguanidine bicarbonate to perchlorate by slow addition of perchloric acid. Again, in the end, I got pure, slightly acidic solution of nickel and aminoguanidine perchlorates. To precipitate NAP, I added solution of sodium hydroxide. Better to not use ammonium hydroxide, I'll explain later why. Precipitation was immediate. After 15 minutes, my product was filtered. The yield was 2.1 grams, or 60% from theoretical. I also tried to make NAP by the second method, that uses much more commonly available ammonium perchlorate as the source of perchlorate. This method is similar to what I saw in Doug's video, but instead of mixing all three ingredients in one beaker, I split the synthesis into parts. I prepared a solution of nickel and aminoguanidine perchlorate separately. Nickel perchlorate was prepared by boiling nickel carbonate in solution of ammonium perchlorate. Need to boil it for a while to get rid of as much ammonia as possible. Unfortunately, you cannot boil off all the ammonia because it bonds with nickel and forms a complex compound. After approximately half an hour, some of nickel carbonate was still undissolved. I gave up trying to dissolve it and just filtered the solution. Aminoguanidine perchlorate was prepared in similar way, by boiling aminoguanidine bicarbonate with solution of ammonium perchlorate. It dissolved quickly, but I boiled it for a while, until smell of ammonia almost disappeared. Why need to get rid of ammonia? This is a solution of precipitating NAP, and now I add ammonia solution. Not too much, only 2 moles per 1 mole of nickel. As you can see, solution turns blue. NAP immediately dissolves and blue nickel complex is forming. I even isolated it. This unknown complex is energetic too, but not even close to NAP. This way I figured out that ammonia is bad for this reaction. Any excessive amount of it increases NAP solubility. So let's get back to our perchlorate solutions. I got two nice and clear solutions of nickel and aminoguanidine perchlorates. Then I mixed them together. Because nickel solution has some ammonia in it, you can see immediate reaction and precipitation of NAP. After 15 minutes, precipitation is complete. Solution has neutral pH and green color. That's a good sign that we can get additional NAP by adding sodium hydroxide solution. I filtered NAP and added sodium hydroxide to the filtrate. Unfortunately, I added too much, and solution turns blue, that is bad, and indicates the presence of ammonia complex. Since I have perchloric acid, this is not a big problem. I just added few drops of it and adjusted pH to slightly basic. I repeated this reaction a few times and my yields were from 1 to 1.4 grams of NAP. That is not good and corresponds to 31-43% from theoretical. Also, there can be a situation when after mixing two perchlorate solution, I got strong basic pH and blue solution. Precipitation of NAP was slow and incomplete. That means that excessive ammonia is present. That's very unlucky and requires addition of perchloric acid to neutralize it and adjust pH to slightly basic. So that was my results of NAP synthesis. If you have any idea why my yields was so low, please write in the comments. I've heard that 90% yields could be achieved. That's all, bye.